Autism spectrum disorder, or ASD, affects roughly 1 in 44 8-year-olds in the United States. Though there is no cure for ASD, early diagnosis and access to the right therapies and resources can make all the difference in the life of a child and their family. Autism affects people of all races and backgrounds, but the access to early quality care is not the same for people of color. And while the latest data from the CDC shows a decline in racial and ethnic disparities, Black children are still at a disadvantage when it comes to a timely and accurate autism diagnosis. Now, researchers from Florida Atlantic University's Center for Autism and Related Disabilities, or CARD, are working to find out why. Joining me now to share some of their findings is Dr. Torica Exume. She is clinical support specialist for FAU CARD, and she's coordinating the Florida Developmental Disabilities Grant to study the underrepresentation of Black children in autism. And she joins us now with more on their findings. Doctor, welcome. Thank you for joining us on this very special and important program.
Thank you for having me.
So go ahead and tell us about FAU CARD. What services does it provide, and why is it so vital to helping children with ASD?
Yes, so here at FAU CARD, we have family members that will come in and meet with an assigned clinician who is an expert in ASD, as well as other areas such as special education, behavior analysis, and social work. The assigned clinician will meet with the family members and provide an overview of FAU CARD and the services and supports provided. Then we register the family, and then we conduct a needs assessment with the family to develop a plan to meet those needs that the parents are expressing. Whether it is training or consultation or technical assistance to the individual with ASD. Additionally, the families will receive regular email blasts with events on parent trainings, professional trainings, and supports. And all of these services and supports here at FAU CARD are offered at no cost to the individual and the family.
So as we have been discussing, autism research, as we know, has been going on for years now. But you say Black children are diagnosed on average a year and a half later than white children, thus delaying their care. So what's happening here? Why is that occurring?
So Black children meeting the ASD diagnostic criteria shows very low numbers, as we can see. Black children are 2.6 times more likely to receive a misdiagnosis than white children, 5.1 times more likely to receive a misdiagnosis of an adjustment order, or 2.4 times more likely to receive a misdiagnosis with conduct disorders. And these issues are reoccurring due to the underrepresentation that may be consisting of Black parents experiencing cultural barriers and seeking ASD identification and treatment for their child from both healthcare and the educational community. Pediatricians may also show a lack of understanding the red flags of ASD, or educators may show a lack of understanding the red flags as well and confusing the red flags with ASD or for ASD with developmental delay, DD, or emotional behavior disorder, EBD.
So, Doctor, you mentioned culture. Talk about that for a moment, about culture and how it affects diagnosis and care for these children.
ASD symptoms and signs are not that easily recognized by Black parents. There's also the fear of stigma within the Black community. When we look deeper into the Black community, Black parents face barriers in obtaining ASD identification and starting services for their child. They are more likely to mistrust healthcare professionals and others aiding their care in identification process due to poor or failed client-patient relationships and the lack of cultural perspectives. Black parents may be unaware of the delay of identification or initiation of treatment for their child until they have been in the identification process for a lengthy period of time. Black parents have voiced the lack of acceptance of ASD identification within their own communities, and there's also a lack of knowledge of ASD. These barriers altogether held Black parents back from receiving an ASD identification and agreeing to treatment for their child.
We know you and your team have conducted multiple interviews. You've talked to pediatricians, you've talked to providers and caretakers and the like. What have you discovered from those conversations?
What we've mainly discovered is the lack of professional development, the lack of cultural understanding, the lack of teachers wanting to be more involved with parents, or parents wants it to be more involved with teachers and accepting that teachers are reporting certain concerns. But this has to be in a timely manner. So for Black children, usually it's a conduct disorder at an early age, not ASD red flags. And this is the problem that we're having. So because these are so-called conduct disorders or behavioral issues that the child is experiencing at a young age, they're not diagnosed with ASD till they're about 9 years old. So if we can improve our professional development trainings, improve developmental checklists, then we may be able to identify these signs in Black children from an earlier age, such as 3 or 4 years old, and that would make a significant difference.
So, Doctor, this research that you have been conducting is crucial to bridging the gaps that are out there when it comes to care for white children and children of color. That's really the focus of this research. So how much longer are you going to be working on this?
So we were just renewed for another year, so this will be our second year conducting research. And during the second year, we're going to reach out to 11 more counties throughout the state of Florida. So we're going to target North Florida, Central Florida, and South Florida again. And this time around, we're going to reach out to various populations such as university professors, other psychologists, Black teachers, Black professionals to get their input here so we can really dive into the problem here and develop a solution, a one-for-all solution for the state of Florida.
Well, your work, Doctor, is so important. We thank you so much for joining us today and talking about it.
Thank you.